This is Daily Blast Live. We're talking about what you're talking about.
Because everyone's talking about this.
Always live, always real, always unpredictable.
You are totally off base here.
Log on and join our live conversation.
I can't believe I'm saying this. I do agree with you.
DBL starts right now.
Welcome to Daily Blast Live. It is Tuesday, May 7th. We are live, and we're talking about what you're talking about right now. I'm here with Tori, Jeff, Al, and I am Sam. Let's get started. We have our brand new interview with pop sensations Pentatonix joining us from their first ever world tour. Plus, we have wedding guest fashion secrets. We're telling you how you can look your best without, of course, upstaging the bride. Come on now. All that in minutes. The stars brought their craziest, most over-the-top looks ever to this year's Met Gala. The theme was camp, notes on fashion, and everyone was expected to pull out all the stops, but hold up, what is camp? Well, it is defined as the love of the unnatural, of artifice and exaggeration, basically everything that is fabulous, ironic, or extra. So let's get to the fashion, and the title this year for the most lit definitely goes to Katy Perry, whether you hate it or you like it. She definitely is having people talking. She wore this illuminated chandelier look. It was created for her by Jeremy Scott of Moschino. Kim Kardashian showed off her figure in this skin-tight latex corseted dress by Kiara Mugler, who came out of retirement to create the look, which took you guys 8 months to complete, by the way. It appeared to be dripping wet, thanks in part to the crystals and shimmering material. Katie Holmes and Jamie Foxx made their public debut as a couple last night. While they didn't hit the pink carpet together, the couple did pose for photos with one another inside, and Kendall and Kylie Jenner broke out the feathers for their camp looks. Kendall wore a bright orange feathered Versace gown, while Kylie opted for a lilac look with a fur stole, I'm hoping faux, and a matching wig. Actress Janelle Monáe embraced wearable art with this custom Christian Siriano look, and the eye even winked as she walked down the pink carpet. Come on now. Lady Gaga served up multiple looks for her grand entrance to the event, all created by Brandon Maxwell. It started off with a huge pink dress that took an army of men with umbrellas to wrangle. She then stripped down to a black dress, followed by a skin-tight pink dress, and then it all ended up with her posing in her underwear. Here it comes. Yes, girl, with huge platform shoes. Serena Williams wore this stunning neon yellow Versace gown with pink feathery leaf accents, and she paired her look with neon Nikes. Jennifer Lopez sparkled in this beaded Versace dress with a plunging neckline and fringe detailing. She wore a matching headpiece, and of course, A-Rod. I mean, Tori makes a good accessory, am I right? Okay. Lupita Nyong'o embraced the rainbow with this Versace gown with pink star pattern and rainbow ruffles. And check out the gold Afro picks in her hair with raised fist logos. Yes. Jared Leto, my favorite, had the best accessory of the night, a custom replica of his head. He brought it along while rocking this red Gucci dress. Kacey Musgraves looked like a Barbie doll in this hot pink Moschino leather dress, pairing it with a blow dryer bag and cat eye shades. Cardi B won the award for the biggest train with this red feather Tom Brown gown. The 10-foot-long train nearly took over the pink carpet. And Ciara might have won best hair of the night. I think she won, let's be honest, with this very extra, gorgeous afro. She also wore a custom Peter Dundas emerald green crown because she is a queen. And Zendaya had a fairy tale moment at the gala, transforming into Cinderella in this Tommy Hilfiger ball gown with white poofy sleeves and a skirt that lit up. Yes, yes, yes.
Sam, you drink some water, we'll talk.
I actually looked at I looked at Jeff midway and your eyes were closed.
Dude, I was out. I was thinking about cheese and crackers and what I'm going to do tonight.
You know what I was thinking? I'm like, this coffee's bitter. I should think about a different kind of coffee.
I guess I'm the only one that really appreciated
it,
the looks as art.
It's like
say
all
what
these people
you
got
want.
Together to entertain us.
Like, I agree. That's
all, I mean, it's just like somebody's got to shake it up a little bit. We all can't wear khakis and polo shirts.
Thank you.
Somebody's got to shake it up and push the envelope a little bit. That's
I'm
what art
for
does.
Universal uniforms every day.
Like Star
what?
Trek?
Yes.
Boring.
I wear the same thing to work every day. That's fine with me.
Yeah, that's a man of a certain age. I do the same thing. I got those green sweatpants. They can walk to work themselves.
Yeah. I've noticed that, too.
Now, Tori, did you have a favorite, even though I guess you were bored by it?
No, I did have a favorite. Ezra Miller, I thought, absolutely nailed camp. And this is a guy that is gender fluid, and he used prosthetics as the
eyes. Wow. Wow.
And you really got that candy.
Wait. Those weren't real eyes?
I know. I don't know why I said it like that. Those were real eyes. But it's about the artifice and the exaggeration. And I like the gender fluidity. That was all over the red carpet.
It was.
The pink carpet, excuse me.
Yeah, I loved that, too. I'm with you.
I'm going to nod my head and pretend like I know what artifice means.
Like the artificialness. Like, it's fake. Like, camp is very kitschy and fake and overdone.
Right.
Now, what does kitschy mean?
Campy.
Okay, thank you.
Now, Al, we do call you Al Fashion Jackson.
Yes, ma'am.
So you had to have a favorite.
Oh, my boy Nick Jonas. We go way back. But I just he looks like
a Littlefinger.
He looks like a waiter at the Cheesecake Factory, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Like Dubai.
Yeah.
In Dubai.
Makes me hungry.
Cheesecake Factory. That's a good one. You nailed it. Jeff, do you have a favorite?
Well, listen, I know everyone hates Kylie and Kendall, the Kardashians, or the Jenners, I should say. Check them out. They look terrific. But I don't like that they didn't walk with their dates down the red or the pink carpet.
Oh. That's a good one. Hey, I think all the work that these fashion designers put into these outfits, I really want to give them some credit.
Sam, who's your favorite?
Janelle Monáe.
Yes.
That is a work of art. That dress is art, you guys. And then again, with the gender fluidity, I think that Jared Leto with that gorgeous red Gucci gown. And then who doesn't love a severed head as a purse?
I really didn't even notice he was wearing a gown. And I think that's the way, if you don't want people to notice, just carry another head. I really did not notice he was wearing a gown until you said something.
Wait, that's a purse?
I believe it was a purse.
I think it was, or an accessory, but he held it like a purse.
He held it like a purse.
He sure did.
I'm all for it.
So we don't know.
I don't know.
Now, what if Mark showed up with a purse of your head?
Fashion.
Yeah, exactly. Fashion. All right, let's get to this next story. An update to the college admission scandal. Lori Loughlin's defense might have just gotten a boost thanks to the University of Southern California's crew team. TMZ reports this ad for the team is posted all over campus. You can see it says no experience, no problem. Some say the poster could help Lori's defense, that her daughter's lack of experience doesn't matter. The team doesn't require experience to join. Lori, of course, is accused of paying bribes to pass her daughter's off as athletic recruits in order to get them into USC. Now, Tori, I know you are our legal eagle. This makes my blood boil.
Yeah.
Because if Lori Loughlin is going to use this as her defense, she's suggesting that all of us are stupid.
Yeah.
She's suggesting that everybody out there that has worked hard to get into a university, whether you are an athlete, whether you are as a scholar, again, is stupid. So could this work for her?
Yeah, it could go both ways, right? It could backfire completely because it's so obvious. We have her on tape being like, take a picture of them on rowing machines and send it in. We know the real thing. She insulted so many people when she pled not guilty. That's really where she made her mistake, as we've talked before. Now, it only takes one person to be like, maybe she didn't know, though. So they are using the loophole defense. It's a long shot. It's a Hail Mary, but it's worked before. And all she wants to do is avoid prison time.
And I think she's going to do that.
You do.
And I don't think so.
I think she's going to. Listen, she's not calling us stupid. Our judicial system is calling us stupid. The lawyers that defend her are calling us stupid. Because if she gets off, it's just proof that our system does not work.
You're right.
And that's what's going to happen. She's going to walk you could buy your way out of jail if you have enough
money.
Many
would argue our system works in the opposite way because you do have women of color that are locked up for, sending their kid to a public school in a different zip code.
Yes.
So, Al, does the judicial system work or does it not work, depending on how you look at it inside what lens?
I think it's working perfectly.
Unfortunately.
It caters to the rich. I mean, if you are rich, you don't see jail as a deterrent. Like, anybody that's got some money, you can get a good attorney. Tori, you know this. The reason lawyers cost different amounts of money and some are free is a free lawyer is going to be like, Sam, take the deal. Whereas a great lawyer is going to go through everything. Did they say the or the when they Mirandize you? They're going to figure out, and all they need is one thing, and that's why you pay that money. And if you have money, you're going to get that lawyer, and they're going to get you off. So that's why Jeff feels like that, because it's true.
It's disappointing. Shame on her and shame on the judicial system.
Yeah.
We need reform, and we need reform now. DBL is live. We will bring you breaking news as soon as it happens. Coming up, a cappella never sounded so good. The band Pentatonix takes time to chat with DBL in the middle of their first ever world tour. Then an eye-opening study all about sunscreen. The surprising new findings that might make you rethink the kind of sunblock you use. And you, the viewer, are our fifth host. And we want your take on this controversial story. A bartender is in trouble after prosecutors say she overserved a man right before he went on a shooting rampage. Should she be charged with a crime? Send in your comments right now. We are live and we're going to read them next. Welcome back to DBL. It is time for Fifth Host when we talk about what you're talking about. A Texas bartender has been arrested and charged for over-serving a man the night he shot and killed eight people. Lindsey Glass is accused of violating a state law by selling alcohol to an intoxicated or insane person. Police say she should have known to stop serving the man because he appeared drunk and armed. Turned out his blood alcohol level was more than four times the legal limit. After leaving the bar, the man killed his estranged wife and seven others before dying in a police shootout. The bartender now faces up to a year in prison, a fine of $500, or both, should she be charged with a crime. Now, she wouldn't be charged for murder. This would be a misdemeanor, so to speak. I just want to clarify that.
Sad story. Bobby from Facebook says, I think the bartender is responsible for keeping patrons from becoming unreasonably intoxicated, but only the shooter is responsible for murder. Bobby, great take. You used the perfect word there, unreasonably intoxicated, and with your BAC at four times the legal limit, that means that you probably can't stand up. The fact that this man was armed, at least to the point where she was aware of it, I think that she should be implicated in some way. I don't know. My whole thing, I'm not about throwing people in jail. I mean, this could be used to teach other people. I mean, you shouldn't have to teach people not to serve drunk people with guns, but some people got to learn that lesson, I guess.
Yeah.
Patty from Facebook says, bars are just out to make money. They don't care about the dangers of alcohol. This needs to change. I know, Sam, you were a bartender. And you
Jeff,
can speak,
too.
And Jeff, too. And there are very strict laws about serving people that you can reasonably see are over-served.
Oh, they make an example out of you.
Oh, yeah.
In Los Angeles, it's a corporation called ABC. They train you. They make sure to let you know about those red flags. And God forbid you over-serve someone. Both Jeff and I have cut many people off.
Yeah.
But we've both seen people, our colleagues, dragged out of that bar in handcuffs to make
for
a point
serving.
Because of a DUI. You could kill someone, you could kill yourself.
Right, they don't bring them out the back door. They make sure all the servers see, they bring them out the front door.
It's a
to
big
make
deal.
An example, like they handcuff them. So it is a big deal.
And serving a drug, alcohol is a drug.
And I think you should be liable. If you're a gun maker and you sell to an underage person by mistake, you're liable in that, and they shoot people, you're also liable. So I think she broke the law.
And I do want to set this up, though. We've talked about this story, we set it up for a minute. We don't know if this guy was coming up to the bar.
Totally.
We don't know the whole, what was going on. Obviously, I've seen someone fall out of a chair. I know to cut them off. If they're all over the place and they're coming to get drinks, I don't know. I'm not responsible.
Yeah, are they drinking in the bathroom?
Right.
Are they properly
did they drink
trained?
Before they came?
Good point.
So there's a lot that goes into this. We can't just speculate on what the bartender did or did not see. But Marcus from Facebook says, how would the bartender have known what this guy was going to do after he left the bar? Hold people accountable for their own actions. Marcus, I love you for saying that. Accountability, I think a word that has been erased from the dictionary. Be accountable for your own actions. Not because your fifth grade teacher gave you an F and called you a name, that's why you went and shot up everybody. Not because the bartender overserved you, that's why you went and shot up everybody. Hold this man accountable. Does this lady need to do her job depending on the circumstances? Maybe. This man's accountable, not anybody else. He's the one who killed eight people. Let's not forget that.
Got it, all right.
Sorry.
Wow, great takes, everybody. Thank you for writing in. Coming up on DBL, eat better, sleep better? Uh-oh, I'm already sold. We've got the top foods that a nutritionist says will help you get a good night's rest and pop sensation. Pentatonix joins us for the first time. Find out why their unique a cappella style is wowing audiences everywhere when we come back. You just want attention.
What you just heard involved no instruments, only five voices. That's a cappella band Pentatonix, and they just kicked off their first world tour. I caught up with three of the band's five members in today's Chatting with the Stars. Scott, Mitch, and Kevin, welcome to Daily Blast Live. Pentatonix are about to kick off a world tour, but I'd like to talk to you about your early days. You guys made your mark covering popular songs on YouTube. Is there a song or artist you have not covered yet, but you've got your sights set on?
We haven't really done a Taylor Swift song. We tried.
We could do the new one.
Yeah.
Exactly, yeah. That'd be really, really fun.
And you guys have kicked off your world tour. yet there are still some critics who still say you guys are just a cover band. So how do you respond to that kind of criticism?
I don't think it really bothers us. At the end of the day, like, we take songs that we love and do them in a way that only we can do them, which is a very special, I think, ability that we've kind of created over the past few years. And it's been really, really fun getting into original music. It's a journey, and we're just so thankful that we get to have time to continue to grow.
I want to play a rapid-fire question game with you all. I've decided that I'm calling it the Akka Answers with Pentatonix. So are you ready?
Let's go.
First one, who in the band is always late to rehearsal?
Oh, Kirsty.
I always like 5 minutes late, too.
Yeah.
Me too.
But yeah.
Who is the mum of the group?
Kevin, I think.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, you're the most organized.
Okay,
and
well,
moving.
Thank you, I appreciate that.
Who calls their mum the most?
Probably you do.
I call my mom every day.
That's cute, good son award, good son award. Who's always taking selfies of themselves?
Probably us.
Or Kirsty.
Oh, Kirsty does take a lot,
yeah,
too.
Kirsty takes a lot of selfies.
Who's always snacking?
Snacking?
I feel like you or me.
Not me.
But Scott, probably Scott.
And the last one, now this is as a group, what's your favorite song to perform?
I think Bohemian Rhapsody.
Yeah. Is this the real life?
Yeah, it's a crowd pleaser.
All right, so okay, since that's your favorite, do you mind giving me a little snippet?
Oh my god.
It's hard enough with five people.
Yeah, we only have three people with this right now.
It would sound like nothing if the three of us did it.
I would offer my services, but believe me, your ears would be damaged for life.
Yeah.
It'd be awful.
Yeah.
Thank you guys so much, Scott, Kevin, and Mitch, three of the five members of Pentatonix, who are on a world tour right now. Check these guys out. If they're in a city near you, you will not regret it. Thanks, guys. You've been awesome.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.
Promotional consideration is brought to you by
Welcome back to DBL. Making the right food choices can be tough. And today's So Nutritious, sponsored by So Clean, Tori Schulman meets up with a nutritionist to learn about foods that'll help you sleep better. Take a look.
Hey guys, we are here with Sarah Peternow. She is a holistic nutritionist at Family Nutrition Services, and she's here to tell us how food can affect your sleep. I know, mind. Talk to me about how sleep and eating go together, because I never thought about that.
Absolutely. Who hasn't had trouble sleeping at one point or another? I know I have.
What are some specific foods so I know to stock?
There are foods that are rich in an amino acid called tryptophan. The first one is
turkey.
Yeah, exactly. That's why everybody's so sleepy on Thanksgiving.
Right.
But nuts are a really good accessible source of tryptophan. Almonds, Brazil nuts, walnuts, just eating a quarter cup of these per day can really help to boost your tryptophan levels, which converts in the body to serotonin.
Wow, so you'd be nuts not to do it.
You would be totally nuts not to do it.
All right, so what else other than nuts?
So my favorite one of all is actually cherries. Cherries, when they contain melatonin, they actually just help to contribute to your body's own production of melatonin.
Wow.
This sleep hormone is one of the hormones that regulates like our circadian rhythm.
So cherries, nuts, what else?
Fish is actually a sleep remedy. And it's
really
not thought of, but it should be, because it has a very high level of vitamin B6.
And B6 helps you sleep.
Vitamin B6 is actually important for that conversion of tryptophan to serotonin.
Oh, I see.
So when we're talking about nuts, you know, we use the amino acid in our bodies to convert to serotonin, but if you're low in B6, that conversion doesn't take place quite as naturally.
I want to thank Sarah Peternow for dealing with me, first off, and for teaching us some accessible things you can do right now at the grocery store to help your own body naturally get to some Z's.
I guess I need to stock up on cherries, because Mama hasn't been sleeping.
You've been having some trouble, and she also mentioned to me yogurt. So if you make a smoothie and include all of this, yogurt, cherries, walnuts, you can sort of make a sleepy time smoothie.
Great.
So if you think maybe, you know, right when you're feeding Soph, maybe you give yourself a little sleepy time smoothie and you get in the mood to sleep.
Here's what's coming up next on DBL.
Entertainment icons take fashion to an outrageous new level at the annual Met Gala in New York. But who came dressed as a burger? Then sunscreen danger exposed. The new FDA study that might make you think twice before slathering sunblock on this summer. And our wedding series continues with the most flattering looks for guests. We've got something for everyone when we come back.
Is Daily Blast Live. We are talking about what you're talking about.
Because everyone's talking about this.
Always live, always real, always unpredictable.
You are totally off base here.
Log on and join our live conversation.
I can't believe I'm saying this. I do agree with you.
DBL starts right now.
Impressive.
3, 2.
Welcome to DBL. We are live and we're talking about what you're talking about right now. So let's get started. Today, we are going all in on the Met Gala. It's one of the biggest nights for fashion and the amazing looks don't stop at the pink carpet. Stars brought all the style to after parties as well. Let's start with Kim Kardashian's Big Bash. She changed into this bright blue outfit with a blue and silver wig, and her sisters went all out too. Check out Kendall Jenner in this suit and Kylie in this bright feathery number. Looks like a big theme this year, Tori, is having your hair match your outfit. Tracee Ellis Ross looked stunning in this sparkling purple jumpsuit too, but singer Katy Perry really stole the show with this look by Moschino. Yes, she's a cheeseburger, you guys. Seems like she was definitely the life of the party, but some people were confused by it. Take a look at this video.
We gotta go, Katy.
What?
We gotta go. Hi, J-Lo.
That was J-Lo in the bathroom. Let's take a closer look at J-Lo's face. Which, did she approve? I think she's almost side-eyeing it. A little bit of a side eye. Hey, I'm all for everybody's fun looks last night. I love the push for gender fluidity. I love all the fashion designers showing off their craftsmanship. But what kind of craftsmanship comes from a styrofoam burger?
Yeah. I mean, people look like they're
hating.
Totally. Why not? Why can't she express how she feels?
You know why? Because I don't think it went with the actual theme.
Me too.
You don't eat cheeseburgers when you camp?
No, but camp.
Oh, no. Oh, my God.
And no, you don't.
Okay, wait.
You don't eat cheeseburgers when you camp.
We can't blame.
What?
Hold on.
No.
Wait. We can't blame Jeff. So the theme is camp. It doesn't mean camping like pitch a tent like we're doing, by the way, next weekend. Yeah. No, it means campy like kitschy.
Oh, because I was so paying attention the whole time.
Yeah, did you think this is a wilderness thing?
Otherwise, I'd show up in a sleeping bag and be comfortable.
Yeah.
But it's supposed to be this kitschy, unwearable, sort of artificial look of, it's really what drag queens started.
Yes.
Nina Sway wrote, "Black drag queens invented camp on the Met Gala pink carpet." So it's this over-the-top look. The burger, what are you doing? That's not what you're doing.
Tori. I agree. Sorry.
I don't care for it.
I agree. I'm no fashion expert.
You're about to swing and miss, though, with these things.
She always swings and misses.
Does she?
I don't care.
She's
for Katy Perry.
A billionaire.
I guess you're right. Okay, that's a fair point.
A big theme last night was gender fluidity, as we just mentioned. And actor Michael Urie leading the charge.
Yes.
Christian Siriano created this gender fluid outfit with a pink gown on one side and a suit on the other. He's also wearing a boot on one foot and a heel on the other. And it was hard to miss Billy Porter at the gala in a gold jumpsuit and wings. He was even carried in like royalty.
That's how I feel right now.
Frowned upon. That other guy was just as two crazy people.
You know how long it takes to make that?
That is beautiful.
The other guy was half a man, half a woman.
All right, let's get to Danai Gurira from Black Panther.
Woo.
Rocked it on the pink carpet. Her top hat look was inspired by Oscar Wilde.
Ooh.
She tweeted out this photo for comparison. And finally, we need to mention Harry Styles. The singer wore a blouse with a bow and tells Vogue, quote, "I think fashion is supposed to be fun, and I think it's a good time for that right now. People being who they are and stuff."
He's so eloquent.
But do you see the difference? Like with the Christian Siriano look, there's craftsmanship there, and it is pushing the narrative of gender fluidity. I mean, you've talked a lot about how Jaden Smith and all these people that are coming forward saying, let's have more inclusive fashion, just because gender norms back in the day were very specific.
And I think we have David Bowie to thank for this.
Boom.
And you want to know what's more interesting about that? When Lady Gaga finally took off everything and she laid on the carpet like this, the one thing showing was her David Bowie tattoo in her stomach, and I thought, he's the man that started this all.
You're absolutely
right. He's the
right.
one who had the androgynous idea to make that mix before anybody.
And when it was criticized back
oh,
then.
Criticized?
Yeah. I know now.
Can you imagine like what he went through, like what people used to yell, I'm sure, at him mm-hmm. because no one had seen anything like that before. Now it's like, oh, and I think he paved the way for people like Prince to come in. Remember yes. what Eddie Murphy wore in Raw? That was a little gender fluid.
The leather outfit.
Yeah.
You're right.
Men did not wear stuff like that.
And Dennis Rodman, remember when he was doing The Athletic, when he was a basketball player and wearing dresses, everyone thought it was crazy.
Oh, yeah.
Now we're seeing, you know,
he
Dwayne
was a little
Wade.
Crazy, though.
He just was to crazy. Be, yeah. But Dwayne Wade, you're seeing athletes really
it's
go
true.
That way.
Those are the pioneers.
But what brings people together other than food? Cheeseburger. I get it,
okay.
Katy Perry.
Yes. Right.
I get it. Okay. Al's with me now.
Right, right in my face. Cool. one big star missed the Met Gala last night, but she had a good excuse. Comedian Amy Schumer and her husband welcomed a baby boy Sunday night, but she did make it to the Met. This is a photo of her at the Met while they were setting up. She apparently took this photo on the way to the hospital, and of course, that's not the only baby news. We're getting more news on the royal baby. We'll get to meet Meghan Markle and Prince Harry. Oh boy, their son tomorrow. Still no word on a name, but congrats to the couple. And now we're hearing from Prince William and Kate for the first time. Listen.
Obviously thrilled. Absolutely thrilled. And looking forward to seeing them in the next few days when he's quite down. I'm very pleased and glad to welcome my brother to the Sleep Deprivation Society that is parenting.
What a difference. I mean, this is a beautiful moment, but what a difference to see Meghan Markle, the way she's handling it, with Kate, and then even to see your girl, because you've toured with Amy Schumer, you know her,
yes.
to see how open and honest she was. I think we lack transparency when it comes to pregnancy and childbirth, and your girl did it right, in my opinion.
I think she really did, and you know, but honestly, you know, Amy is allowed to be Amy. Meghan Markle can't show up at the gala wearing a t-shirt and jeans and being like, hey, this is me, and I felt sorry for her. I really liked the way Amy handled this, to just be able to be a person, to not have to be looked at as a star or a sex object, just somebody bringing new life in the world and having fun with it. Yesterday I was, when I was leaving the building, I ended up talking to Jordan for a minute while Jeff was coming out, and I saw the boys in the back, and I was like, they have no idea how cool their parents are. And like, that's how I feel about Amy as well. It's like, your mom is super dope.
It's true. You know, Jordan, one thing that I love about your wife, if you guys follow his wife, Jordan, her Instagram stories, she is so candid about pregnancy, about childbirth, and I think we need to be. When I was pregnant, I had no idea, number one, that my uterus was going to grow from a pear to a watermelon within 10 months. That's insane. And that my abs were going to separate, that my ribs were going to separate, that my back was going to get bigger. Like, literally, your body completely changes. Not to mention, when you do give birth, it's miraculous, it's beautiful. But it takes like a month to stop bleeding. I'm sorry if I'm being this graphic, but I think it's important.
No, this is a graphic thing
to discuss. This is biology, and I think it's important that we talk about it in a real manner, because look at Kate. Kate Middleton came out of the hospital 4 hours after giving birth.
It's so unrealistic.
Because of that pressure to present the baby with her hair all perfect and the makeup on.
And notice what the difference is, right, between William and Harry. What happened in between? Their mother died, and what happened was she had to be that person. She was chased always. The paparazzi got her, and I think Harry, who was young at the time, said, no, I'm not going to have a marriage like this. I'm not going to have a baby like this. I'm marrying someone very different, and we will not be doing what the British press want us to do.
And what do you always say about Meghan? She modernizes.
Modernizes the monarchy.
Amen.
I think Tori just made the royals interesting. I was like listening like, oh, it's interesting.
It's true. Yeah. All right. Moving on, we do have an update on Britney Spears' health. Her mom says she's in dire shape and is taking her concerns to court. Oh, no. Raquel Villanueva has the news at the moment. Raquel.
Well, Lynn Spears says her daughter Britney needs her help right now and is asking a judge to get involved. She wants to see Britney's medical records and treatment plan as soon as tomorrow. The singer recently left a mental health facility and is reportedly still in bad shape. Right now, Britney is under conservatorship run by her father, Jamie, who is recovering from some serious health issues of his own. Britney's parents are divorced, and TMZ reports Lynn is staying with her daughter. As of now, her mom is not asking to be a conservator. TMZ also says the parents are at odds over her care. Britney's father wants structure and discipline and worries her mom will be too lenient.
Wow. Thank you so much, Raquel. We are thinking of you. Britney Spears. DBL Nation, listen up. We have a warning about an article that might send you into a panic, maybe for no reason. I say it is. You're probably seeing the headlines today that chemicals from sunscreen get absorbed into your bloodstream and can remain in your body for 24 hours. But don't throw away all of your sunscreen just yet, just some of them. The study found that the Food and Drug Administration looks at four common chemicals in sunscreen, including oxybenzone, which is known to affect your hormones, you guys. They only studied 24 people, and they do not conclude these chemicals are bad for you. They just want more research done. So here's what you should know. Anything you put on your skin will be absorbed into your body. It's your largest organ. A proposed rule from the FDA would recognize two ingredients are safe and effective. They are, write this down, titanium dioxide, that is safe. Zinc oxide, that is safe. They are also proposing that PABA and toluene, as well as salicylate, are not safe and effective. I think this is really important. Again, when I was pregnant, you learn something, right? When I was pregnant, they tell you on those very bottles, not safe if you're pregnant or breastfeeding. So if it's not safe for my child or for a pregnant breastfeeding mother, why would it be safe for anybody else? So what I can say to everybody, make sure you buy those brands like Aveeno. Another really good one, I think we have a full screen of it. This is a fantastic one. You can get it at stores like Aaliyah. Suntegrity. Fantastic, because there are no chemicals here. So you can put it on, you can put it on your baby. And there's also stores out there like Aaliyah. If you're in Denver watching right now, they have two locations here. Everything in there, chemical-free, toxic-free, vegan, cruelty-free. You can put it on your body and feel safe. And I think that is so important.
I'll tell you this, Sam. You have, like, working with you, obviously, it's great on the panel, but I've learned from you off the panel in terms of, like, how much due diligence you do with the things that you put in your mouth and the things that you put in your body and the things that you give to your child. And I honestly didn't. I was like, I'm like my dad. I'm an old black guy from Cleveland. I'm like, it's fine. It's fine. Eat that. I ate that and they're fine. But look around. Look how many people have cancer. Yeah. Look how many people are sick.
I know.
There is something going on. And if God forbid something happens, at least I would like it to be with materials that were organic, the things that at least try.
Well, look at our own Samantha Harris, who came on our panel. You guys know her from Dancing with the Stars, from E.T. Samantha Harris said the reason why she got cancer, she says, was because of all the chemicals she was putting on her body, as well as the chemicals she used in her home to clean.
There might be something to that.
Yeah, other countries have those chemicals banned. So we gotta be diligent about it. We really do. And spread the information, right?
Absolutely.
Coming up on DBL, our wedding series rolls on with the best dresses for guests. We've got you covered no matter what style wedding you are attending. But first, Al Fashion Jackson sounds off on the Met Gala's most memorable and strangest looks. Don't miss his hilarious take that's coming up next.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Yep. Music, please.
All right.
We're gonna do a step, regular step. Cannot and will not ever understand this. How will you?
What do you want me to say?
Go out!
Tomorrow on DBL, classic stars, where are they now? With Donna Mills from Knots Landing. Can you believe she's 78?
I adopted a child at 54. That keeps you young.
Behind-the-scenes secrets from the cul-de-sac. Why she loved playing bad girl Abby Cunningham. And would she ever do it again?
I would love to see a Knots Landing reboot. Would you want to do that if there were one?
That's tomorrow on DBL.
Welcome back to DBL. Last night's Met Gala still has everyone talking. Celebs ran with the camp theme, which is exaggerated fashion and anything extra. We saw a lot of that, so I'm gonna break down the night's craziest looks with Al Fashion
Jackson. Let's do it, girl. Steph, I'm excited.
Okay, so let's start off with Katy Perry. So she tried to light up the red carpet in this chandelier dress by Jeremy Scott, but Al, this look left me in the dark. I mean, I'd rather see the dress with the lights off.
Yeah, and
sorry, KE.
You know, she's such an advocate for, like, you know, saving the environment. That's wasting a lot of energy, so I think she missed with that one.
And then she thankfully changed out of one dreadful outfit, only then to dress up as a cheeseburger.
What's wrong with that? As long as it's the Impossible Burger, because I'm watching my weight doing a 10-day challenge.
Oh, okay. What about next up, we have newlywed Nick Jonas. He wore a white Dior suit with matching metallic shoes, bejeweled shirt and tie. I think he looks dashing. Al, what do you think?
I mean, my only question, Steph, is, like, why can't I wear this?
You could.
You know, I want to show up dressed like Liberace sheets. I think he looks great, you know, but honestly, you know, money's tight and he just looks like the kind of waiter that comes over and just tells you your card got declined.
Oh.
So, I don't know, we have to go to the next one.
Okay, Cara Delevingne.
Spain supermodel. She looked like a pack of fruit stripe gums in a Dior dress. My sweet tooth loves the look, but Al, what you thinking?
Steph, I'm thinking two words, candy pimp. She looks like she got in a fight with a pinata and lost. But finally, we got a Barbie that we know goes to raves, and I love a party girl.
Okay, don't hate me, Al, but we have to talk about the Kardashians and the Jenners. The baby of the bunch, Kylie, wore a feathery Versace gown. I think she looks like a sexy, shiny, plum fairy.
I mean, she definitely looks sexy because, like, she reminds me of, like, a real-life living version of Lil' Kim's nipple boob cover.
Cleveland Browns wide receiver Odell Beckham Jr. wore a kilt, a hat, and no sleeves, leaving me with no words. Al, I know you love Cleveland, but I think this is bringing some shame to your city, love.
It's that outfit's only acceptable if you're getting dressed in the dark after a one-night stand. You know, I mean, the only way that could be worse is if you stand on an air vent like Marilyn Monroe. But you know what? Odell Beckham, he's going to get us some championships, so it's fine in my book. Super Bowl or bust, baby. Let's go.
Thank you for your fashion creators, Al Fashion Jackson, everybody. Fashion Talk continues on DBL coming up next. I'll be showing you some of the most flattering styles for wedding season without Al, sadly, but we will be right back. Welcome back to DBL. Have you ever been invited to a wedding and thought to yourself, what on earth do I wear? Whether the wedding is on a beach or in a church, we've got you covered. I went to the Bridal Collection here in Colorado to ask our DBL master stylist, Jordan, what should you wear when you're a guest? Wedding season is upon us. We all know someone who's getting married. It's your next door neighbor, your grandkids and your friends. So we need things to wear. I'm gonna meet up with my bridal bestie, Jordan, and she's gonna show me three different looks for three different types of wedding. Between us, we've got this. Oh, wow, look at you.
Isn't this gorgeous?
Beautiful.
So Alicia's in more of a formal look.
Okay, so is that kind of like a black tie?
Yeah, so on the invite, it's gonna say formal. The men are gonna be wearing tuxes. And so this is a really great kind of happy medium. It stands out, it's gorgeous, it's elegant, but it's totally modest with the high neck, three-quarter sleeve, and then the A-line skirt is just universally flattering. You know, this is an evening wedding. You wanna look gorgeous, but you also wanna make sure you're not trying to outshine anybody else. Isn't this gorgeous?
This is so cute. This is beautiful.
Really gorgeous wrap dress. This is really gonna be nice and flattering. It's gonna show off the waistline. It's gonna have a little bit more of kind of a skirt on it, so it's gonna flow beautifully. Mm-hmm. This is definitely something too I recommend wearing like more of a spank with. I always rock mine underneath. That way if the wind blows, you don't have to worry about anything showing.
You have no idea.
No, and it just smooths everything out.
So when you're wearing spanks, do you want to like squeeze yourself into a smaller size or should you go for the right size?
Okay, so these are large and these look like a child's large.
I was going to say, stretch out. Teeny.
You are going to lay on the ground, you are going to sweat, you're going to pull them up. It's not going to be
pretty.
But it's not about it looking pretty on the inside. In a case like this, you've got to be a little bit more pretty on the outside.
And I just think this is a dress you can wear again and again and again.
Absolutely.
Oh, wow, you look so elegant.
Isn't Tina gorgeous?
Yeah.
She's showing off more of a traditional kind of wedding look, so it's going to be more of like your afternoon ceremony.
So this is more like the church kind
of service. Yes, yeah, like 2 o'clock ceremony, 5 o'clock reception look. And this is going to be gorgeous and tailored. You have this beautiful slim fit. It's really going to show off her figure. I love the seam lines coming down because it's going to highlight that gorgeous chest and then show off her beautiful waist. She also has these phenomenal legs. Now, if I were her with these legs, I'd shorten this bad boy up a little bit, but it depends on the person.
I like
you can still squeeze a spank underneath here. You know, if you got it, flaunt it.
Yeah, the whole look is absolutely stunning.
Isn't it? It's so classic. I love this teal. Teal is such a good color for weddings. It's a really beautiful traditional tone. It looks good on all skin colors, and it's gonna transition perfectly from day to night.
I love it. This is the look.
We'll be right back.
Promotional consideration is brought to you by.
Welcome back to DBL. Actor Kevin, bless you.
We've been on break for 20 minutes.
I swear, I couldn't hold. I thought it was going to be a one shot.
You know what I do? I drink water when I feel a sneeze coming.
Oh, I couldn't hold that one. Oh. Sometimes it feels good. They have a good story, though, too.
Great. Actor Chris Evans is just like the rest of us, right? He has a high school reunion. Captain America stopped by his own reunion for his Massachusetts high school over the weekend. The 37-year-old posed with classmates for the 20-year reunion. Cool. This all comes as Avengers Endgame continues to rake $2 billion worldwide.
He had a little name tag that said Chris.
We all know who you are.
Ridiculous. We know you're Captain America. Give me a break.
So he can't go to his homecoming, to his class reunion? Because he's famous?
Do you think he was trying to get attention?
He's going to get attention. He's in the biggest movie of all time. People are going to notice when he walks in the room.
So he's damned if he does.
Absolutely. Stay in his house.
To go, maybe.
Huh? He might actually
like
those people.
Go.
Changing your tone.
We'll see you tomorrow, same time, same place. Bye, guys.